all honesty, you guys, if I had known that Colourpop was going to drop theirs, I would not have bought this one. Hey guys, welcome back. If you're new here, my name is Chris, and today we're going to dive into the Lemonade Palette by Midas Cosmetics. If you're new here, know that I am holding a 2K giveaway. So if you want to join that giveaway, you can go ahead and click the link that's going to be in the description box or the link that will be in the pinned comment. So the packaging of this palette is very, very simple. It says lemonade up top. In the back of the palette, it has the names of the shadows, and it says when life gives you lemons, you make lemonade. The palette does come with a sleeve, which is the same in the front. In the back, it does contain ingredients. Up top, you can see that the first two ingredients is talc and mica. So if you're allergic to those two ingredients, do not buy this palette. This is a cruelty-free palette, and it has a lifespan of 2 years. I'm not sure where this was made, whether it be in China or here. It doesn't really say it on the palette or on the sleeve. The inside of the palette does come with a very large mirror that does fold all the way back. It's also a magnetic closure, just a soft magnet. And here are all the colors up close. This is a monochromatic palette that is the color of yellow. Now I want to push pause for just a second. If you are a makeup lover and you know about Colourpop Cosmetics, then you know that they just recently released their yellow monochromatic palette called Honey. I do want to answer some questions that you might have in your head right now. Midas Cosmetics did not copy Colourpop. This palette was revealed and was available on pre-order on June 10th. Colourpop revealed their palette on the 25th or the 24th, one of those 2 days. Now let's compare prices. This palette costs $18. I did use one of my YouTube friends called Nessa CX Beauty. I used her code to get a discount on this. That code would give you 20% off of this palette. You still have to pay for shipping, so it'll be $5 shipping. Altogether, I paid $19.40. Now the Honey palette by Colourpop costs $12. I know that's cheaper, however, when you add the tax, you add the shipping, and even if you throw in a discount code, it comes out to $17.75. So the difference in price is only $1.65. So I do want to just put that out there in case you're like, well, why would I spend $19 when Colourpop is only $12? It's not when you add all the other fees to it. I pre-ordered this before knowing Colourpop was going to drop their yellow palette. In all honesty, you guys, if I had known that Colourpop was going to drop theirs, I would not have bought this one. And it's not because this is bad, but because I know Colourpop formula and I do love their formula. So in a way, I am grateful that I didn't know about that because I got to try a new indie brand. I've never tried Midas Cosmetics. So in this palette, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 mattes and 4 shimmers. There's no sense in this, by the way. This doesn't smell like lemons. I did do some pre-recorded swatches. Everything was pretty much swatched 2 to 3 times, with the exception of about 3 shades. I don't judge a palette off of a swatch. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys 4 shadows swatched right now. There is absolutely nothing on my arms. I think that's really important to say. Nothing on my fingers. There's no primer, no nothing. I'm gonna go ahead and take Sweet, Squeeze, Fresh, and Juicy. Here they are on my fingers, whole lot of yellow. And I'm gonna put them right here. This is 1, 2, 3, and 4. Here we go, right there. This yellow shimmer right here, it really doesn't have that much of a shine. I'm gonna add some more right now. See that? That's a lot better. But again, like, the shine is what I'm talking about. Like, that shimmer shine, you don't see it that much on your arm. However, I am wearing it in the inner corner of my eye. And I don't know if you guys can see it, but it definitely does reflect nicely off of a light, and I am happy with it. For this eye look, I used 3 brushes, one from the GLF Cosmetics. This is the one from the Princesa Azteca Volume 2 palette. I've reviewed that one recently, and I didn't show this in action, so I wanted to show it today. I use a Morphe 326 brush, and I also use the Itzy Times Tetris brush. It's just a flat brush. So I used every single color in this palette except for this one on my eyes today. I used the GLF brush, the fluffier side of the brush, and I went in with Sweet. I didn't go heavy with this color because I used it as a base color, but it did show up, and you can build it up to make it more pigmented. The next shot I used was Juicy. I put it right on top of Sweet, and it definitely popped. You can see it on my eyes. It looks really stunning. And I did build it up to what you see on my lids. After that, I went to Bitter because it's the darkest matte in this palette. I went ahead and I tapped that into the outer corner of my eye. After tapping, I went ahead and I blended it up with Juicy, and it was really easy to blend, which is always good to know. Next, I went into Shimmers and I used the other part of the GLF brush, which is just honestly a flat brush, like a packer brush for shimmers. I didn't wet the brush first because I wanted you guys to see how the shimmer performs dry. I went in with Tarte right here with a dry brush and it did not show up. It wasn't that great. Definitely wear your brushes for the shimmers in this palette. It comes out so beautiful after you wet the brush. To follow that, I went in with Frozen because it's a lighter yellow shimmer, and I put that in the inner corner of my lid to kind of just blend it from light to dark. Then I took my Ipsy brush and I went back into Bitter and I put on my lower lash line, started from the back all the way close to the front. Then I took my M326 brush, I wet it, and I went in with Frozen and I put that in the inner corner of my lower lash line. Then I took Zesty and I put that as my brown bowl highlight, again with a wet brush. And then, as I said earlier, I took Squeeze with a wet brush and I packed it in for my inner corner highlights. And then I took Fresh, which is this green yellow matte shade, and I ran it underneath Bitter and blended it out. I put on some liner from Glamlite and some lashes by Bombshell Cosmetica called Selena. On my lips, I used a ColourPop Lippie stick in the shade Ziggy. And then I put on my brows off camera because I almost forgot to do that again. And that's it, you guys. That is the entire look that I did with this palette, minus just one shadow. Let me know your thoughts and comments down below. Let me know if you're gonna go for the ColourPop one or if you're gonna try the Midas Lemonade palette. I'm exhausted. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.